The School of Design La Loggia in San Andreu. The site is framed by Del Pare Magnanet and Del Camp del Ferro. The building can be accessed from the Berenguer de Palou. The project, renovated in the early 50s by George Chinchilla Ballesta into a school, consists of six large warehouses of about 1,200 square meters each and a height greater than 8 meters with large windows. The warehouses are covered with signature to the building, rounded slope roof with skylights opening towards north. But although it may seem radically modern, this school has a long tradition, is the oldest of the design schools in Spain and one of the oldest in Europe. The general program of the project, following the instruction received from the trade union work of vocational training, adapts to the site through two perfectly differentiated groups separated now by a green area of silence, the representative, administrative and the workshops. The old Hispano Suiza factory, La Fabrica Pigasse de Barcelona, was built in an architectural scenario to show the government's economic plan, has worked for 4 years and shut down in 1950. This building, now definitive, aims for the future to house all the artistic and design specialities of Escola La Loggia. The school is dispersed between multiple buildings where all have their own uses. The main concept is five modular buildings in the middle of the plot and contribute as the workshop space. The plot is separated in two zones, administrative and workshops. In the middle of these two is the green space, which is called the silent area. The building is composed by a general entrance hall developed on a single floor, central building with offices, services and management housing developed over 4 floors, library, assembly hall and concierge apartment, forming a unit to the left of the central body, the back in contact with the workshop area to classroom body, dining room service with 300 places and its adjoining premises. The green silent area aims to isolate the two groups of buildings, ensures that the relationship between the different rooms follows a logical and functional order. The entire administrative area is related to each other by closed steps and connected to the dining room and classrooms. The classrooms relate internally with the administrative area and with the exterior steps with the workshops. The structure utilizes structural elements as decorative and functional. Natural light is mostly brought into the workshop area with sawtooth roof, exposed brick on walls. The assembly hall is partially treated with wooden wall wear and decorative paintings. The library with wooden coating and the rest of the building simply with paint on plaster. The lighting in the workshop space is crucial. There are two sources of light, sunlight coming from the skylights in the semicircular roof and artificial light coming from the fluorescent lamps installed in the studios.